In this lecture, we will discuss about the minimum certification standards. The Central Seed Committee has established minimum standards for seed certification, which have been adopted by all the seed certification agencies throughout the country. They can add some standards according to the local needs, but cannot delete any standard. The minimum certification standards can be broadly divided into two categories, general standards and specific standards. The general seed certification standards are applicable to all crops. These standards have been determined for all the factors affecting the quality of seeds in general. Specific standards for maintaining genetic purity and quality of different kinds of seeds have been established for different crops. Specific standards are further divided into two categories, crop standards and seed standards. Crop standards consider the factors which affect the genetic purity and general health of the standing crop. Seed standards consider the factors which affect the seed quality of the seed lot. There are total 18 general standards for seed certification. The word seed used in general standards shall include all propagating materials used for raising the crops, which may be seed, fruit, or any vegetative part of plant such as stem, root, leaf, etc. The purpose of seed certification is to maintain and make available to the farmers the high quality seeds of notified varieties. High quality means physical and genetic purity both. Seed certification is done by a state seed certification agency notified under Section 8 of the Seeds Act 1966. The seed standards are determined by the Government of India on the recommendation of the Central Seed Certification Board. Only the seeds of crop varieties notified under Section 5 of the Seed Act 1966 can be certified. The varieties to be notified soon can be certified temporarily, which can be rejected later in the absence of notification. Breeder seed is the source of foundation seed, and foundation seed is the source of certified seed. Certified seed may be the progeny of certified seed, provided this reproduction does not exceed 3 generations beyond foundation seed stage first, and it is determined by the certification agency that the identity and genetic purity will not be significantly altered. Such seed means certified seed produced from certified seed shall not be eligible for further seed increase under certification, and the certification tag shall be superscribed with not eligible for further seed increase under certification. A certified seed grower will have to submit all the proofs to state seed certification agency, such as certification tags, seals, labels, seed containers, purchase records, etc., as may be demanded by the agency in order to confirm that the seed used for raising the crop has been obtained from an approved source. For the purpose of seed certification, the entire area sown by a seed grower up to 10 hectares under one variety in different fields not separated by more than 50 meters shall constitute one unit. The fields of different varieties and fields separated by more than 50 meters shall be regarded as separate units for the purpose of field inspection. Seed grower should strictly follow the farm techniques and guidelines which the certification agency thinks necessary for maintaining physical and genetic purity of the seeds. The responsibility of educating the certified seed growers regarding the techniques used in seed production rests on the seed certification agency. The inspection of the seed crop should be undertaken by trained persons authorized by the certification agency. Processing of the seed is essential for its certification. The seed lot under certification will have to be treated with proper fungicides and insecticides for the seed-borne diseases as per the guidelines given by the certification agency. The seed certification agency will take samples from the seed lots under certification and get them analyzed in its seed testing laboratory, means central or state seed testing laboratory, to ensure that the seed lots meet the required certification standards. The minimum genetic purity of foundation certified and hybrid variety seed must be 99%, 98%, and 95% respectively. The certification agency has the authority to refuse certification of any seed field or seed lot that does not meet the minimum standards prescribed for the crop. Under Section 11(1) of the Seed Act 1966, the seed grower may appeal against the decision of the certification agency to the appellate authority, who will communicate his decision to the seed grower. The seed certification agency will provide certification tags, and sealing of the lot will be done under its supervision. The certificate will carry informations like name, address, and monogram of the certification agency, name of the crop, variety and class of the seed, purity percentage, lot number, name of the seed grower, date of issuing certificate, and validity period, etc. The color of the tags for breeders, foundation, and certified seeds shall be yellow, white, and blue respectively. The seed obtained from the seed crop affected by adverse climatic conditions such as drought or excessive rains, which meets the prescribed standards for genetic purity, will be certified as substandard seed under Section 6A of the Seed Act 1966, and the standard for which the seed is poor shall be mentioned. The validity period shall be 8 months, which can be extended further for 4 months. In specific standards, first of all, we will discuss about crop standards. Crop grown in the previous season is called as preceding crop. To avoid contamination from the same preceding crop, the field selected for raising the seed crop must be free from the seed-borne diseases and volunteer plants. Generally, such field is not selected in which the same crop was grown in the previous season. In some cases, if the same variety was grown in the field and the seed crop met the prescribed certification standards for the genetic purity and disease infection, such field can be selected. Isolation distance of seed crop is required to avoid contamination due to natural crossing and disease infection by wind and insects from neighboring fields. Isolation distance depends upon the mode of pollination of the crop. Generally, 3-meter isolation distance is kept for self-pollinated crops, whereas for often cross-pollinated crops, it is 30 meters, and 200 to 400 meters or more distance is kept for cross-pollinated crops. The seed crops have to be inspected at different stages of crop growth, as pre-flowering, flowering, and maturity stages, for verification of genetic purity and removal of off-types. The number of inspections and stages of crop growth when they should be conducted vary from crop to crop. Various contaminants are found in seed crop, such as objectionable weeds, diseases, off-types, and inseparable other crop plants. The weeds whose seeds are similar in size and shape of the crop seed are poisonous, and plants of which are difficult to eradicate once established, serve as an alternate host for for crop diseases and pests and have a smothering effect on the main crop are considered as objectionable weeds. For different crops, such weeds have been designated. For example, Phalaris minor for wheat, wild rice for paddy, chicory for barseem, dodder for lucerne, and Argimon mexicana for mustard, etc. All the plants infected with the designated diseases should be rogued out, such as loose smut of wheat, grain smut of sorghum, smut, ergot, and grainier disease of bajra, mosaic of peas and tomato, mosaic, brown rot, scab, and wart of potato, etc. The purity of seed of the main crop variety is affected by pollination and admixture of other variety seeds. Plants deviating significantly from the characteristics of a variety as described by the breeder in any observable respect are considered as off types. Seeds of other crops mixed in some crops which are difficult to separate are called as inseparable crop plants, for example, barley and oats in wheat. The maximum permissible limits for the above mentioned contaminants have been fixed, so at the time of inspection, it is verified that these contaminants should not exceed the limits. For example, in certified seed crop of wheat, objectionable weeds, diseased plants, off types, and inseparable other crop plants should not be more than 0.02%, 0.5%, 0.05%, and 0.01% respectively. In specific standards, next we will discuss about seed standards. After harvesting, threshing, and processing, the seed lots are sampled and analyzed for purity, moisture, germination, etc., for which the minimum standards have been fixed. The seed lot cannot be certified if it does not conform these standards. For example, a certified seed lot of wheat should not have less than 98% pure seeds and not less than 80% germination percentage. The maximum permissible limits for moisture content and inert matter are 13% and 2% respectively. Size of seed samples for different tests for different crops have been prescribed. The seed lots are graded on the basis of the size of seeds, so the seed size in seed lot should not vary beyond tolerance limits. For example, a seed lot of potato should not contain more than 5% tubers of different size.